We're a community-based applicant for Dom Music. My inspiration was based on the issues that are found in the music community. One is on piracy, and secondly is artists claiming their names. So the first issue, let's say you go on Google or Bing and you search for popular artists or any independent artist followed by the term MP3, the chances are you will find pirated content. So 9 out of the top 10 results will lead to a pirated content where you can download the music for free. Unfortunately, the artist will not make any monies on this. So with Dom Music, the goal was to create a safe haven so that artists can benefit, and also fans will know that if they visit a Dom Music site that it's authentic, it's the actual artist, and that the monies go to the community as opposed to the pirate networks. And the second issue is one of the artist's name. A lot of the bands have generic names. So if, for example, Eagles or Queen, they don't own queen.com or eagles.com. Even Justin Bieber doesn't own justinbieber.com. So the idea with Dom Music is A, have all the artists claim their names. So people don't even have to use Google. They can just go direct to the browser and put in queen.com, eagles.com, prince.com, and they will go to the actual artist's official website. We have a globally protected marks list of all like the major artists, so no one can register those names if they wanted to. So any artist that has a significant amount of sales or touring, those are placed on the globally protected marks list for music. So we're protecting them first, and we have a very responsible launch process to facilitate that. But fans do play a big role. If you look at Kickstarter or other places, fans are becoming the funders of these artists, especially like do-it-yourself artists. And we believe they play a critical role. Yes. It's primarily for artists, but also for professionals as well. So let's say music producers, engineers, music attorneys, A&R, all the music constituents. Even the manufacturers of instruments, educational institutions, arts councils, music information offices, ministries of culture, export offices, the list is quite long. It's for everyone. The biggest fear is obviously it doesn't become adopted, and it becomes another area where people can infringe on the rights of the artist and the copyrights. So it becomes a piracy haven and it confuses people. So if it says Dom Music, people will get confused and think, hey, this is legal content, which if it's not done right, it's going to be problematic. But we're tackling this problem head on with our policies and also getting the support of the entire music community space, and as well as all the constituents, and we're under a multi-stakeholder governance. Success is for users and music fans recognizing that, hey, if we go to Dom Music, it's going to be a high quality content, and if we buy something, it's going to benefit the artist and the music community at large.